Hello, my name is Nicholas Taylor. I'm the Web Archiving Service Manager for Stanford University Libraries, on whose behalf I'm pleased to announce the restoration of the earliest websites of the SLAC National Accelerator Laboratory, including the oldest U.S. website. You can browse this content and observe its evolution over time via the newly launched Stanford Wayback at wayback.stanford.edu. In this video, I'll take you on a brief tour of some of the interesting resources and developments reflected in the archive. On the Wayback homepage, thumbnails show the progression of the key SLAC web pages from 1991 to 1999. Less of a homepage and more of an information retrieval service, the first U.S. web page provided links to a SLAC directory and a high-energy physics preprint database, what Tim Berners-Lee once called a killer app for the web. The website was put up in December 1991, a little over a year after the very first website was created at CERN in the fall of 1990. Stanford Wayback allows us to see how this page changed over time. This page remained unchanged for at least 4 months, after which the number of resources expanded greatly. By March 10, 1995, the page was moved to a new web address, which we can also follow in the archive. Here we find a slightly more modern-looking version of the Spires page, now with an ASCII art header. Starting with the August 25, 1994 capture, the first references to the SLAC homepage that we found in the archive appeared in the page footer. Another first here, this was the first SLAC webpage to incorporate an image. We can see numerous resources organized into subsections on the page. The last version of the page in the archive references the migration of the SLAC homepage to a new server. Unfortunately, none of the links on this page will get us there, so we'll go back through the Stanford Wayback Home. This page was interesting because it was one of three homepages that existed simultaneously. Their idea was that different types of information seekers would prefer different presentations of the information. However, it was the SLAC welcome page that later became the dedicated homepage, and starting with the September 1, 1998 version, we can see the move to a more modern design and more public-oriented subsections. This was approximately 7 years after SLAC launched its first website. There are many more pages to explore in the archive. This brief tour just provides some highlights. For more information about the SLAC early websites and to access the Stanford Wayback, please consult the links below. Thanks.